Hello, welcome back to Pleasantview. Today it's time to meet the Langerak family. And that is Kaylynn Langerak and her children. As you were a bit spoiled in the previous episode, she lives over here in this apartment building. So let's join the family. All right, so here we are in the apartment building. And it is the one I renovated from the lot bin that I showed you in the previous episode. So I will just move down to Kaylynn's apartment. So this is a mirrored version of the one that Ricky lives in. So they have the entrance here with a small living room space. And this shelf with a record player and their phone as well. And then they have the kitchen table, as well as the very newly renovated kitchen. No, this is really, really old. And then we have little Natalia's bedroom. That's what that looks like. And they have a very small bathroom right here. And then we have Kaylynn's bedroom. And this is the little bed for her youngest child as well, Irina, who's currently at the daycare center. So we will meet her later in the day, but not yet, unfortunately. So that's what that looks like. So we will move on to the character presentations. So this is Kaylynn Langerak. And for those of you who are very familiar with her character, might notice at once that I have changed her aspiration into romance instead of family. And that was something that I did as soon as I started to play her, because to me, that makes more sense in her storyline, being a maid who seduces her customers. So, I changed that, but instead I gave her the secondary aspiration of family. So she still has that, but she's more geared towards the romance side of things. And her lifetime wish is to woohoo with 20 different sims. So I think that that suits her a lot better. And as for personality, she is an Aquarius. And she is one of those sims in this neighborhood who was born with quite different traits than what she has currently. Looking at the thin white lines, we can see that she has become more neat, a lot more shy, more active, more serious, and a little bit more nice than she was when she was born. So that tells me that she has had very stern parents who have meddled a lot with her personality growing up by encouraging her to be in certain ways. Looking at her fitness level, she is just barely fit, and her hobby is tinkering. And looking at her family tree, we can't see any extended family, but she has two daughters. It is Natalia and it is Irina. And Natalia is the daughter of Daniel Pleasant. And Irina is the daughter of Goopy Jill Scarbo. So I know that Kaylynn and her family, the Langeraks, appear in The Sims 3 in Sunset Valley. But I haven't really taken The Sims 3 into account when I started playing this neighborhood, because, well, for one thing, in that neighborhood in The Sims 3, Kaylynn is the same age as Mortimer and Bella, and that just doesn't make much sense to me as a The Sims 2 player. And there's also the land grab family in Sunset Valley that messes things up a bit for me. So to me, I have considered that the Goths have been in Pleasantview for generations, and that the land grabs have been in Blue Water Village for generations as well. And as for Kaylynn, I have created a bit of a different storyline for her. And that is that she actually grew up in a completely different country. In a wealthy family, I think that her father might have actually been a nobleman in that country. I think of her mother as still being Ileana Langerak and her father as being Dustin. And I also think that she did have an older brother called Parker and an aunt called Zelda. But yeah, I don't think that it was for me in Sunset Valley. So Kaylynn has always been a very family-oriented person, and she has always just had that at the front of her mind to look after her family, and that was what she wanted to do with her life, even as a young child, was grow up into a mother and become a housewife, really. She had her older brother, Parker, who liked to sneak out at night and meet with girls, and Kaylynn usually covered for him when he tried to both sneak out and sneak back in so that their parents wouldn't be suspicious. She did things like that around the house. Her father was very lazy and had a hard time keeping a job. And he just liked bumming around the house, really. And Kaylynn enjoyed just being around him and helping him out, cleaning up after him and things like that. But Ileana had other ambitions for her daughter, and she really pushed Kaylynn into becoming a copy of her, basically. She wanted Kaylynn to follow in her footsteps and become a successful businesswoman. So even though Kaylynn really only just wanted to meet a man and get a nice and big family with a lot of kids, that was not what her mother wanted for her. So Ileana pushed Kaylynn into getting a teenage job at the same business that she was working at. And Kaylynn turned out to be very good at that job because she was starting out as a sort of mailroom technician, I guess, taking care of all the mail and the reception desk and doing errands for people and preparing meeting rooms and getting documents and things like that. So Ileana's boss also noticed Kaylynn and liked to ask her for things all the time. And she eventually became a little bit like his assistant as well, to get documents for him and help him prepare for meetings and write down notes and things like that. So Kaylynn spent a lot of time in Ileana's boss's office helping him out. And one of those days, that big boss man had his son with him. And as soon as Kaylynn laid eyes on him and they saw each other, they fell in love instantly. It was one of those teenage romances that they just thought that they had found the love of their lives, and they started going out. They didn't really tell their parents about it, but they were around the same age, and they started to fool around, and being a very young and inexperienced girl with heart-shaped eyes, Kaylynn just fell for him, and one thing led to another, and unfortunately Kaylynn ended up becoming pregnant as a teenager. In other words, she was all of a sudden pregnant with the child of Ileana's boss's son. So things grew very, very messy. And, well, both of them being teenagers still, it wasn't really acceptable that they would be intimate in the first place, and to actually have a baby on the way wasn't at all something that was acceptable for Ileana's boss, and he made it quite clear that that was not a grandchild of his. He would not accept that, and he implied that that Ileana should make Kaylynn get rid of it. And as a result of all that, Ileana's relationship with her boss was really, really damaged. And working in business, it's all about having the connections and knowing the right people and being friendly with everyone. So that really put the stopper in Iliana's work life, really, because she found herself not moving forward in her career after that point, and she grew quite bitter from that. So she tried to speak with Kaylynn and explain everything to her and ask her to have an abortion and get rid of that child that was on the way, because she was a teenager, she couldn't really take care of a child right now, and seeing as who the father was, it really wouldn't be possible for her to keep and raise that baby. But being so family oriented and being so devoted to that child already, even as a teenager, Kaylynn refused. So she carried through all 9 months and eventually gave birth. What Kaylynn didn't know was that her mother had gone behind her back and found a couple in this country that Pleasantview is in, that was childless and had tried to have children of their own for so, so many years, but just couldn't make it, and who wanted to adopt. And they had made a deal. Iliana had explained the situation to them, making it sound like Kaylynn was very, very young and hadn't meant to get pregnant, and that she didn't want the baby, and that it was so emotional for Kaylynn that she didn't want to even meet them or speak to them or lay eyes on them. So having that in mind, those parents traveled to their country to meet with Iliana, and one of those days when Kaylynn left her baby behind with her mother to, well, go to school, those people visited with them and took the baby away. And after that point, Iliana and Kaylynn's relationship was destroyed, because Kaylynn had been so betrayed by her mother for adopting away her child, and she just couldn't wrap her head around why she had gone through with all of that behind her back. And her mother tried to argue that it was for her own sake, that it was in order to make sure that Kaylynn had a future, because for one thing, if she wanted to find a good husband, she would have a really, really hard time finding one, because she already had an illegitimate child with someone else, a child that she had had as a teenager. And she would also have a very hard time to move forward with her education and her future work life as a single mother, and that just wasn't the life that Iliana wanted for her daughter. But none of that was good enough an explanation for Kaylynn, and after that point she really just broke ties with her mother and would not speak to her, would not even look at her. And seeing as the rest of her family more or less took Iliana's side, Kaylynn didn't really interact with them either. Kaylynn attempted to get in contact with the people that had adopted her child to get it back, but there was no way for her to find out who they were. It was something that Iliana had done sort of under the table, so there was no official documentation for it either. And there was no way for Kaylynn, as a young teenage girl, to find out where her kid has gone. The only thing that she could find out was that Iliana had shipped the baby off to this country, because that was something that Iliana accidentally said in one of her angry tirades, and Kaylynn just grabbed hold of that and thought to herself that she needed to come to this country to try to find her baby somehow, in some way. And that was when she started applying for overseas college and moved to this country instead. eventually and became a citizen over here. She just left her old life behind with the fortune and her family and didn't care about any of that. The only thing that she had in mind was that she needed to find her baby. So she ended up in Pleasantview and attended the university here. She didn't really care that much about what her future would be, what career she would take on. So she just finished with a philosophy degree and had some cleaning jobs on the side as she studied. And that was the job that she kept on with even after finishing her studies. And the next few years as a young adult and moving on to adulthood, Kaylynn spent basically doing what she could to try to find where her child had gone in this country. But it just turned into an impossible task. Kaylynn can't even count how many people she have met through the years and how many people she have tried to get contact with, and nothing has really worked for her to find her child. And that was just really devastating to her, and she found herself in a very dark place. The only thing she really had at that point was her job as a maid. And that is a job that she still has. After all these years, she's still working as a maid. And that was the point that really broke her. That made her just let go of all ideas and thoughts of family. Family had just betrayed her all throughout life, and they had used her and they had pushed her to become something that she didn't want, and then they had removed the one thing that was the light in her life, her child. And she couldn't find the baby even though she tried her best, and that was when she broke down and stopped being a family sim. That was when she instead just tried to find comfort in the form of love and romance, and that was when she switched over to a romantic aspiration. And that was sort of a mental breakdown that she made it out of with a completely different personality. And that was the point when she met the Pleasants. So Kaylynn eventually became the maid for the Pleasant family, and working as a maid, she usually moved from household to household, not really sticking with one particular family that long. But there was something special about the Pleasants. Mainly, actually, it was that Mary Sue reminded her so, so much about her mother. And there was just something about the way that Mary Sue and Daniel treated Lilith that just really made Kaylynn hold on to that family and really just couldn't let go of them. She became a bit obsessive about the Pleasants, and eventually when Daniel started showing interest in her, she just fell for him and felt a bit like she had come home a little bit, even though it really isn't her family, but it's sort of reminded her of something from long ago, and she just felt like with Daniel and the Pleasants, that was where she belonged. And she really felt bad for Lilith, sort of just observing from the side when her parents treated her so unfairly. And Kaylynn did what she could from the sidelines, trying to help Lilith out, sort of like what she had done for her brother when she was a child, when he sneaked out at night in and out of the house. Kaylynn usually did similar things to help Lilith. Not that she was working at night, of course, but hiding things away that Lilith had left out, and sort of distracting her parents sometimes when she tried to sneak by and things like that. Just little things that Kaylynn could think of to help Lilith. But of course, Lilith never knew about that. But Kaylynn definitely has a soft spot for her and always has. So Kaylynn worked at the Pleasants as a maid for a very long time. But that eventually came to a stop when she became pregnant. So Kaylynn let Daniel know that she had become pregnant and that she would have his child. And he, of course, didn't want anything to do with that and fired her on the spot. But he agreed to send her money, at least, so that she would be able to raise his child somewhat. And that was sort of where Daniel thought that that would end. But unfortunately, Mary Sue being Mary Sue, she was very conscious of their funds and found out that a lot of money had disappeared all of a sudden. And she managed to press Daniel enough to make him tell her where that money had gone. And she actually brought Daniel with her over to Kaylynn's place and threatened her into silence, really. That just sort of was the last straw for Kaylynn. Any sympathy that she had had for Mary Sue and any bad feelings she had had for having an affair with her husband just really disappeared. And she instead started thinking of it a little bit more like a victory over Mary Sue, because Mary Sue is not capable of having any more children, and that has been a very sad part of her life and something that she has been very upset about. And the fact that Kaylynn actually succeeded where Mary Sue failed in having a child with Daniel, and sort of also proving that it was Mary Sue that couldn't have any more children and not Daniel. Kaylynn sort of looked at that as a victory and managed to actually let the Pleasants go and move on with her life. So Kaylynn has raised her daughter, Natalia, and she has done the best that she can with the funds that she has. She is a faithful Sim, so she attends church a lot, and she has actually received quite a lot of funds as well from the church in order to help her maintain this this household with the very low wage that she has. So growing older, Kaylynn hasn't really seen a lot of Daniel at all. She was actually neighbors for a while with his sister, though, Jennifer. So they are actually best friends, and she actually still loves Daniel, and she's in love with quite a lot of people that she has had romantic relationships with, but she hasn't really stuck with any one person, but has been very happy to be a single mother and just see these men that she likes on the side. Any thoughts of marriage are long past, and she just wants to help her daughters grow up into beautiful young women and live out her life in this apartment and the way that she does right now. She has sort of given up any hopes of ever meeting her lost child and just wants to focus on the family that she has right now. Then we have Kaylynn's eldest daughter, Natalia, who is also Daniel Pleasant's child. She is a fortune sim, and her hobby is cuisine. She is a Capricorn, extremely neat, but also very lazy, and extremely playful, and also very nice, but more towards the shy side, like her mother. And yeah, she has a teenage job as a dishwasher, and that is both because she wants to help out her mother, who doesn't have that much funds, and also because she really likes being in the culinary business, and that's sort of what she wants to do with her life, at least now as a teenager. That's what she wants to do. So Natalia doesn't know who her father is, and that is because Kaylynn has stayed true to her words and her promise to Mary Sue that she would not let anyone ever find out who is the father of Natalia. And Natalia has been a bit angry with her mother for not telling her, but she knows that there is some dark secret there that she just can't learn about. And she has sympathy with her mother because Kaylynn has told her about her origins and why she came to this country and what she was looking for, and all of her sad past. And Natalia just really feels for her mother and tries to help her best as she can. And she has had to let go of the thoughts of her father and has decided that that's not really important to her because he's not around and her mother is the one who has raised her and taken care of her, and that is the important part. So the only thing that Natalia can't really stand, though, is that Kaylynn is so flirtatious and sees so many men, and she just doesn't enjoy the fact that her little sister was born the way that she was. All of a sudden, Kaylynn was just pregnant, and Natalia just had to accept that. I mean, this is a very small apartment, and Kaylynn sees a lot of men, and Natalia has ended up just have to leave the house in order for Kaylynn to get some privacy meeting men, but that's just not possible sometimes. And with a young child in the house as well, and Kaylynn still meeting men, things are just really not the way that Natalia wants them to be. She really wants to earn a lot of money in order to help her mother, of course, but she's not completely satisfied with the way that Kaylynn handles things either. So she tries to mother her little sister quite a lot and take care of her. And even though she also has a job on the side, she really tries to support her mother as well with raising her little sister, sort of, as well. So yeah, so Natalia has had to become quite reliable as a teenage girl at this young age. She doesn't really have a love interest right now, so that is something that we might have to see for the future. It looks like she is the most attracted to Hugo Bendett, but he is, of course, involved with Alba Landgrab. And then she's quite attracted as well to Jason Fancy, who is a romance sim, and also very much involved with Poppy Burb. So, yeah, that's not a very good match, I think, but we'll have to see if she goes down that road. And yeah, otherwise she's also attracted to both Nassim and Archie, both of which also have romantic interests already. So she doesn't really have that much prospects yet, but yeah, that time might come in future for her. She's very good friends with Jolie Brutti, and also quite close with Jason's older sister, Althea. All right then, let's start off the day for them. So Natalia is of course going to go to school soon, and she doesn't have work in the afternoon, so she will be able to take care of her little sister when she arrives back from school. And Kaylynn is of course going to go to work. She works every day, so that's what she needs to do. So I think that Kaylynn is going to serve some pancakes for breakfast, and Natalia can just freshen up a bit. So one thing that can be said for Kaylynn is that she cooks extremely tasty food. She has quite a bit of a cooking skill, and she's of course almost maxed out in cleaning because, well, obviously she works with us, but yeah, she always serves really nice food for her children. And I think that that's part of why Natalia has become so interested in food as well. So it looks like Kaylynn might be talking to her daughter a bit about her future, because growing older, of course, Natalia is soon going to attend the college. And they're sort of brainstorming together, like what Natalia wants to do with her life, because of course Natalia is a very fortune-oriented person, a very ambitious person who wants to succeed at life. And Kaylynn is of course sharing her opinions about not wanting to overexert herself. It's of course completely optional if she wants to work at all. She could become a housewife if she wants to. Kaylynn has been very conscious of leaving all the options open for her daughters to do what they want to do with their lives. And she really wants to make sure that Natalia knows that she can do whatever she wants. But of course, she's a very money-driven person who wants to have a career and succeed at that. So even though she appreciates it, Natalia doesn't really need that advice. She really does want to have a job eventually. Yes, so Kaylynn is just going to put away things, clean up a little bit, and make sure that the house is tidy before she leaves, because her carpool arrives at 9, so she has a little bit of time alone in the mornings after she has dropped off her little kid at the daycare. So that's what she's gonna do. And of course, Natalia is leaving for school right now. I don't think I mentioned that, but Kaylynn is, of course, a tinkering sim, and she enjoys tinkering with some toys for her kids. So she has actually made this little toy box for little Irina. And she wants to have a silver talent badge, so she wants to keep making toys. So that's a nice hobby for her. Okay, looks like she needs to pay rent. Looks like her neighbor Ricky is swaggering over here to say good morning to her. That's very easy access romance she has right there. But yeah, let's just make sure that she pays her rent. She has received a little bit of money, looks like. So that's fine. The rent isn't that high really for her, so. Okay, the landlord interrupted her interaction. Go to work, please. Yes, so Kaylynn is leaving for work, and we will see Natalia arriving back from school later with her younger sister. We got a pop-up message for Natalia. Word spreads fast in this family. Natalia's relatives heard about her report card and they're pleased as punch. They give Natalia 100 simoleons reward for making them the proudest doting family this side of Sim City. Oh, well, what family? Well, I suppose that Daniel might have heard that she has a good report card and decided to give her something. But I suppose that he sent it just to Kaylynn in secret. That's the only thing that makes sense to me. Yes, so Natalia is arriving from school. Okay, you put down the homework on the side. Interesting. Let's just bring it into your bedroom. Yeah, so what we need to do now is that we need to get Irina back from the daycare. So I'm going to take out the sim blender. Teleport, enable summon menu. And it's gonna be Irina Langerak. So I'm going to move in Irina and delete the sim blender. So let's just take a quick look at her. She's going to age up today into a child. So she is the same age as the broke boy. It was Luke. So they will be starting school together tomorrow. And she is a Gemini. Extremely grouchy, apparently. And also very sloppy. So she's not very similar to her mother and her sister that way. But she's very outgoing, active, and playful as well. So that's nice. And we don't know what her hobby is yet, so we will have to find out. And she has been taught all her toddler skills by Kaylynn. So that's nice. So I think that Natalia is just going to snuggle her little sister a bit. So it's going to be quite a while before their mother arrives back from work. So Natalia is just basically going to take care of her little sister for now. And let's see if she can get some leftovers for lunch. So apparently Natalia is thinking about money, and I think that that is at the forefront of her mind at all times, because growing up, they really haven't had much funds at all, and knowing what her mother's situation is, Natalia is really conscious of trying to preserve what they have and trying to do what she can to make more. Gonna have her use the potty. And I think that Natalia might want to watch the cooking channel. Being as ambitious as she is, she she wants to use every given opportunity in order to learn more about cooking and how she can get better at that. I'm just gonna do my little switch channel trick in order to make sure that she actually gets a lot of fun from watching TV. Looks like Irina has gone into her sister's room to use the toy box instead. Let's see if we can get the toy box animation. That's very cute. Let's turn the crank. Yeah, she likes her toy. Yes, I think that they are just gonna spend a little time together. They might play a bit of peekaboo. I think actually she's going to give her some food instead, and then perhaps maybe she can read a bit to her little sister instead. Yeah, we can see on the way that she sort of waltzes around the kitchen, cleaning up stuff, that she really enjoys herself, and she doesn't really mind taking care of her sister this way, and she really just likes to do what she can. And, you know, working as a dishwasher as well, I think that she thinks that that sort of work is really fun too. She's not shying away from hard work, this one. There we go. So it looks like Natalia finished up with the story for her little sister. And as you probably saw, I also have a mod that lets the toddlers learn skills from getting read to. Or well, that goes for children as well. So I think that's nice. Aww, Irina is asking for her sister. That's very cute. She's just barely a bit more closer to her mother, but yeah. These two will be best friends in no time. Okay, so Irina is very, very soon going to age up, and Kaylynn will also arrive back from her work just now, so we will see. There we go. Okay, she aged up and looks like she ran out to greet her mother at once. But I'm gonna have to give little Irina a quick makeover. Okay then, so here she is in her new little outfit. I also put her in a ballet outfit because I think it would suit her quite well to join Nina's ballet club as well. So they will have to scramble for money for that as well. But I will add her to the list for kids who will attend Tuesday. So I'm also going to have to fiddle around a bit with the layout of this, because of course you can't have the toddler bed anymore. and we need to get rid of the high share as well. So I actually think that Kaylynn will sell those things at this point. I think that she does have in her inventory, yeah, she has that share. So I guess that we're gonna sell some things, and I think actually I'm going to move Kaylynn's workstation in here and make this a shared bedroom for the girls instead. Yeah, something like that, I think. I gave her a little corner in there. And I also think that she's going to hold on to the little toy that she got from her mother. So we will have to see if I can figure out what her hobby is. Her father's hobbies, of course, art and crafts. So I guess that she can just take a look at this picture and she can see what she thinks of that. Yeah, it doesn't look like it was arts and crafts, actually, so we'll have to see what it can be. That's exciting. Yes, so the girls aren't that hungry, really, so I think that Kaylynn is just going to grab something out of the fridge. I'm gonna send her to sleep a little bit, just to get her energy up a bit, and then maybe we can see if we can figure something out later. So Natalia has this want that she wants to ask for homework help, so we will see if we can figure that out with Kaylynn after she has done what she wants to do as well. She wants to freshen up a bit and get out of those very restricting maid clothes. So let's have her take a bath. I think maybe Natalia can take the time to catch up with some friends. Why not call up Jason? See if we can befriend him. I'm just gonna take the social down a little bit because otherwise they will hang up at once. And Kaylynn is relaxing a bit after a hard day at work, of course. Manual labor is always very tough for the body, and Kaylynn is really coming up in the years now. She only has 5 days left until she becomes an elder, so she really looks forward to celebrating her 60th birthday and retiring early. Yeah, so I guess she can just watch some TV for now. Let's catch up on the news. And I think that Irina has had quite a lot of sleep by now, so let's wake her up. Okay, so maybe she's into... No, she shouldn't be into tinkering, because that toy box was like the little toy that jumped out at her was giving her tinkering, I think, so she didn't like that. It might be cooking, I guess. But she's quite different from her sister, so I think it might be something completely different. Let's see if she enjoys watching the TV. We can switch through the stations a bit and see if anything pops up. It was sports, actually. Now that's interesting. I mean, if she's into sports, then of course she would want to be in the soccer club rather than the ballet club. And it looks like she's actually talking about soccer with her mother right now. So I think that I need to rethink the club activities for little Irina. So I'm gonna have to change her athletic outfit and make sure that she is in the soccer club instead. That's interesting. That's fun. Okay, so she's going to watch some sports then, I guess. And, okay. Yeah, this is what happens when you have copperfields on the beds if you don't have enough chairs for them to sit in. I think actually only for that reason I'm gonna see if I can get an armchair in there. Maybe something like that. Yeah. Let's just see so that she can actually sit in it. Yeah, no problem. Nice. Okay then, so looks like she has some pimples. So let's use acne cream, use the toilet, and then she can ask her mother to help her with her homework. Okay, so Irina is very outgoing and she already knows some kids from the daycare center. So I think that she would actually give one of them a call. Maybe it would be fun to actually call up Luke since they are the exact same age. Oh, really? Was it the chair that was in the way now? Okay, I don't know. Maybe it's the toys. Let's put the toys away. Yeah, okay, now it works, even though she's standing very far away. I guess it's good enough. Looks like Irina is talking to Luke about going to school tomorrow. So I guess they're both excited. Now, being at that age, school is still a very new and exciting experience. I think it's interesting looking at her face because you can really see the influence of Goopy in the features. But she's really cute, I think. I don't mind that at all. I think there's plenty of Kaylynn in her as well. But looks like she got her father's eyes. Dark blue. Because Kaylynn, of course, has her green eyes. Okay, they actually made friends. That's fun. Yeah, so I'm going to also switch out the athletic outfit for her. There we go. And I'm gonna change the hair too, I think. Because this is more of a ballet hairstyle. So. Okay, looks like they are done in here. Kaylynn might just take some time to resume making clown in a box. And, okay. Natalia wants to go around and clean a bit. Fair enough. Sure, do that. Yeah, I think I'm actually just gonna let her have the same hair for all of her outfits. Yeah, I think that looks good. Let's just keep that for now. She's just a kid after all, so why not? All right, so it's getting a bit late, so I think that she's probably actually just gonna have a snack and then go to bed. So let's grab some cookies. And I think that Natalia is also gonna have some snack. She can have cookies as well. Kaylynn is done, so she can sell that. Make a little bit of money. And yeah, let's make another one. Looks like the girls sat down in separate parts of the room. That's fine. Okay, so little Irina has had her snack, so she's just going to go to bed. And yeah, all of them are really tired actually, so I'm just gonna send them all to sleep. Yes, and that was it for the Langerak family. I hope that you enjoyed this episode and thank you so much for watching. Take care. See you next time. Bye.